process and means of social control. First, we are going to deal with process of social control. Look at this flow chart. Society has been systematically controlled. Started from family, familial control, religious control, educational control, economic or occupational control in workplaces and government or political control. Next, means of social control. There are two important means. First, informal means. Second, formal means. The working of the means of social control have generated immense interest among the sociologists. Social control has always been their, though it operational character has changed from age to age, the norms, values, etc. were always there, but their constituents have always been changing. The present day industrialization, urbanization, quick means of transport and communication, desertion of the villages, mobility of the people, the rise of towns, cities and metropolitan areas, and the mixing of the people, like of which never had been before, has brought the old value to needless. The development of new is stimulating the social control. Social control become formal and institutional when any of the above process becomes structuralized into an institution. Social control is formalized and exerted by duly appointed functionaries and by formally approved methods. Means of social control by informal and formal. First, we are going to deal with informal social control. The important informal means are norms, 2 values, 3 folkways, 4 mores, 5 custom, 6 belief system, 7 ideology, 8 social suggestion, 9 religion and 10 art. First, we are going to detail about norms. Norms are rooted in the institution. They provide the standard of behavior and are regulatory in character. A choice of individual for striving towards the cultural goal is limited by industrial norms. These provide the guideline for action. The norms give unity to the society. They influence the attitude of individuals, norms as blueprint for behavior, setting limits within which individuals may seek alternate ways to achieve their goals. A social norm operative in one social system is not equally operative in the other. Conformity to norms is qualified in view of the socially defined situation. Violator of norms may invite loss of prestige, social ridicule, or even a more severe punishment. Second value, it consists of culturally defined goals. It is held that as a legitimate object of realism for all or for diversely located members of the society. It involves various degrees of sentiments and significance. These may consist of inspirational reference, values or goals worth striving for. These are basic, though not exclusive. Three, folkways. Folkways are people with a community sense. They have a uniform and a common way of living. This constitutes the folkways, simple habits of action common to the members of the group. They are the ways of folk that are somewhat standardized and have some degree of traditional sanction for their persistence. These, in the interest of communal life and uniformity, are accepted binding. Four, mores. Modes are such folk ways as are based on value judgment and are deeply rooted in the community life. Any disregard shown to this invokes sanction. According to Green, modes are common ways of acting which are more definitely regarded as right and proper than the folk ways, and which brings greater certainty and severity of punishment if violated. Five, custom. Custom is a rule or norm of action. It is the result of some social expediency. It is followed as it involves sentiment based on some rational element. It is automatic in character. No special agency is required to enforce it. Any disregard shown to it invokes social criticism. It is enforced as it is. It cannot be stretched to meet the changing requirements. It may, with change of circumstances, fade into non-existence. It at a given time is a force and reflects the social consensus. A law maker has to take it into consideration. Custom is the handwork of time as a blueprint for specific social purpose. It develops over the time. It takes time to evolve itself. Sixth, belief system. Belief system has deeply influenced man's behavior. It has provided the sanction to the social norms and conditioned the growth of culture. It has worked as a means of informal social control. Some of the beliefs hold a significant place in the social system. Belief in the existence of the unseen power has been with man from the primitive age. The feeling of fear made him believe that he is being watched. This seems to be the spirit behind the prayer and meditation, the raising of hands in supplication, the kneeling before the symbol of the faith or such other practices and ceremonials are indicative of it. Seven, ideology. Social determination of thinking is ideology. Social thinking has always been influenced by ideology. Our social thinking has remained influenced by Dharma. Politically, unity of the country has been the ideology. Eight, social suggestions. Social suggestions and ideas are an important method of social control. Through these suggestions and ideologies, the society controls the behavior of its members. Society generally controls and regulates the behavior of its members through many several ways, such as through books, writings, and spoken words of ideas, etc. 9. Religion. It includes these customs, rituals, prohibitions, standard of conduct and roles primarily concerned with or justified in terms of the supernatural and the sacred. Religion is a powerful agency of social control. It controls man's relation to the forces of his physical and social environment. The extent to which religion controls the behavior of man depends upon the degree to which its adherents accept its teaching. 10. Art. It is a method of sublimation and redirection of the instinct of an individual. It is a combination of religion, morality, ideal, and so many things. Art is an indirect and inadvertent manner which trains the child or an individual for either way of life. Second, formal means of social control. Detail going on. The important formal means are education, 2 law, 3 coercion, 4 economic, 5 political. First, we are going to detail about education. Education is a great vehicle of social control. After the family, it is the classroom, the peer group, and the leaders which exercise influence on a child by our ancients. Education teaches moral, intellectual, and social values in individuals. It imparts a sense of continuity. It links one to one's heritage and sets a perspective before him. It gives the social vision of uniformity to the individual and fits him for social role. With the increase in the social role of education, attention is being given to it at all levels, primary, adult, literary, and technical. Second, law. Law is for all practical purposes a general rule of external action enforced by a sovereign political authority. It is the general condition prescribed by the state and the members of body politic are expected to follow it in given conditions. It is uniform and is meant for all. Any disregard shown to it is bound to invite penalty. But as pointed it excited before the state had any adequate means of compelling its observance, and indeed before there was any regular processes of enforcement at all. Three, coercion. Force as a means of social control is as ancient as the society itself in varying degree. It has been used by all societies. Some societies even now resort to force against the deviants. Our society has not given it a high recognition. Traditionally, our political ethics is based on non-violence or least violence. The only state that gave up force and coercion as the instrument of state policy was the Ashokan state. Gandhiji made in non-violence a weapon against the strongest empire, the British. In all civilized societies, penal codes are reviewed to humanize the law of crime. Force breeds revenge. It does not reform. For economic organization. With the rise of modern industrial organization, the increase in the size of communities, a shift in the distribution of social control among the major institutions has occurred. The fear of losing a job compels an individual to follow the rules and regulations of the industry. Five, political. The state has the society's overall regulative system. It is the chief agency of social control. It exercises control over its members through legislations. The policy, the armed forces, and the prisons. Really speaking, emergence of secondary group is a gift of modern complicated social order. In such a social order, the state exercises control through rules and regulations in a more effective way. Law is the most important method of man-made social control. In the other words, law means the code upheld by the state because of its inclusive applicability. It is thus guardian of society itself. State is exercise social control in the most effective manner. Thank you. Have a good day.